Alrighty, hello everybody, welcome back to Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. I am NitePHX. I am with my brother Grey Ghost in Phoenix, and we are flying the Patagonia Bush Trips. We just finished leg 12, and we are about to take off for leg 13, 58.43 nautical miles, and this is where we are heading. There's a runway down here somewhere. I guess once we get here, we'll land on something flat and green and brown, and hope it gives us a completion. So let's click continue, get this loaded up. We've had a few flights on some of these bush trips where you're kind of looking at the landing area and kind of like, huh? But I don't think I've seen one quite this undefined before. Okay, ready to fly. Get the ISO map up, or the VFR map actually. Turn the ISO on. We are going SCEY to SCBR 58.43. miles. Huh. Looks like we might need a little elevation, but not a ton. Let's turn these off. Let's take a look. What's our current altitude? 1,700 feet.
Mine says 1,550.
Oh. Alright, let me hit B. 1,552. Had to adjust the barometer.
You're going to need to go to east and come back again.
Go east and come back again?
Yep.
Oh, and the runway you're talking about, I see.
No, on the server.
Oh, you can't see me. I can see you.
You don't exist again. You're a ghost.
Okay, we'll go here. We will set it to East USA. Go back into the game. Have I disappeared?
Can't tell because you weren't there in the first place.
Yep, but you disappeared though. Nope, now I see you. Check your server.
Yep, you're back. My server currently says east.
Yep, so I dragged you with me, I guess. Because I see you now. Alright, yep. I'm going to go back to west. East USA. We go back to west USA. Zoom. Okay, you are gone. I'm still going to need to turn around here because I do not have enough room to take off here. I think I just heard you. Yep, you're back there. Do you see me?
There you are. Yep, I see you.
Cool. Foiled Microsoft once again. So when I look at your icon, it says you're at 1,610 feet.
Yeah, yours says 1,611.
Okay, what did we do inside here? We didn't set up anything yet, I guess. and go to 3,000 feet as my destination altitude. Okay, flaps are at 16. Let's take this trim down to about 13, I guess. Fuel is good. I'm at 95%.
I got plenty, but let me check my level.
Yeah, let me check my levels too.
20. Oh yeah, definitely gotta change to the right.
Okay, left. Left looks full. So does right, so not gonna worry about it at this point. Alrighty. A bit of a short runway, but I'll lock up the brakes. I'm gonna full throttle it with the brakes on. And we're off. About 30 minutes and then we'll switch tanks. I'm not sure this leg even go for 30 minutes, does it?
Probably not.
This ETV 27 minutes 47 seconds. Still don't know what that means. Estimated time en route?
Maybe.
All right, I think I want to give myself another 500 feet.
Trim instead of taking it down to 23% below.
23% below?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that what you normally have been flying it to keep it somewhat low?
Yep.
Okay. Okay, so next one's going to turn us to the right, 332. Hopefully it does that before we hit the white caps over there. Yep, there we go. Turn into 332. So, looking at the last instructions here, it does look like it is that straight white line for the runway, for the airport, airstrip, I don't know what you call it. Before I get there, or are we going to have to break the autopilot? Alright, we're going to have to break the autopilot. Extra speed to gain some altitude. Feet. Vertical speed mode on. Increase vertical speed. Nav mode on. Which means it's not on. It's autopilot wasn't on. I don't know why things keep getting turned off and not on. And And I think about it, I haven't seen any other planes other than you, me, and Angry.
Yeah.
So are we going to have to try and really get over something up here, or what's going on?
I'm wondering.
We're at 353, so we're on leg 3, I guess. We see a river running north, follow the river that passes by an island at its center. You'll eventually come to a fork, one branch leading off to a lake in the rocky, snow-capped mountains. Ignore this and continue north. Lake. Start gaining altitude as the river twists and bends its way through a small lake at the base of two mountains. So there is a start gaining altitude, but it doesn't, as always, give you any idea what kind of altitude you need. So, let's start gaining altitude. Go up to 7,500. And we'll go vertical speed. I'm going to do it at 600 feet per minute. You know, the tricky part is, okay, yeah, I can gain altitude, and then once you finally get to your destination, you have to lose tons of altitude. Right. And it's not like you can just point your nose down at the ground and descend, because you'll rip your plane apart. Rip the wings right off her. So I thought I had it set vertical speed. It's just all over the place, right? 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 700, 600. Climb rate, vertical speed. Alright, it's just all the turbulence through here.
Yeah.
Okay, we are 6,000 feet now.
Yep, I just hit 6,000. Alright,
looks like we changed course to 352 and hit one from 353, so we didn't notice it. Okay, so lake. Start gaining altitude as the river twists and bends its way through a small lake at the base of two mountains. Okay, so I see the lake. The base of 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 mountains.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, there it is, course change, 13. We got a pool of water. That's a good description. Head north in the lake through the gap between the two mountains. You should see a valley leading up towards an Ohr mountain. So another mountain. Follow it and turn northeast at the mountain. You should eventually find a pool of water and some rocky flats. There are pools of water everywhere. It's pretty sure this got to be this pool of water right here.
Yeah.
You should eventually find a pool of water and some rocky flats. That's rocky and it's as flat as it's going to get up here, I think. Says Rio del Salto Fork. Head north at the pool of water. Am I over it? Yep, I'm over it. Okay, head north at the pool of water. You will quickly see a river you can follow. I don't know why quickly. It should soon lead you to a fork with a branch running west around the mountain. Continue north. So we're going to find a fork with a branch running west around a mountain. And continue north. So we're going to go to the right side of the mountain, I guess.
I see the river.
Change in here any moment. There's the fork and the branch running west around a mountain. That would be that way.
Heading 3-4 here.
Continue north. Three, four, three. Part 7. 13 miles. Rio Tranquilo Flock. There's probably no L in there, probably just Tranquilo. Follow the river through the canyons. Follow the river through the woods to grandmother's house. Take a left. Follow the river through the canyons and valleys. After a while, what's the difference between a canyon and a valley? I need to know. And after a while, you should see a long, narrow lake near the eastern bank of the river. After a while, we'll see a long, narrow lake near the eastern bank and to the right. Of the river. It's beyond us is a fort where you should head east. This kind of looks like a natural crater. Dam here. Yeah. There you are. 1,000 feet above me.
Yeah, I just don't know when I need to start going down. I know this is the second to last leg, but what's ahead of us?
Well, I'm at 7,500. It looks like I can clear everything that I can see.
Yeah, it looks like it now. Pretty close. Start going down. You're on leg 7, and the next one is leg 8, which is the airport.
Okay, so that must be the long, narrow lake you're talking about near the eastern bank of the river. Just beyond this is a fort where you should head east. Just beyond this, I mean, there's a fork, I guess. I hope they don't turn us east here. Okay, so that's not the long, narrow lake. I see the long, narrow lake coming up.
Yeah, I see.
That was Crater Lake over here. It was actually glacier melt. I don't see you. Don't see me either, huh? What's your altitude?
59 and dropping fast.
59? 5-9, huh?
5900.
Okay, so I was looking up. Should be looking down.
Up, I see you way up there. You're almost directly ahead above me.
Yep, I see it down there. Yeah, I think we lost sync again and we just popped back in.
Yeah, probably.
So should I lose some altitude? Looks like I can.
I am.
So this is going to be 10 miles on the next one. Oh, that's the next one is the runway.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm just passing the lake now. I'm about halfway through it.
Okay, so let's... What's your altitude again? 15?
Now I'm at 3,500, I mean.
Okay, let me set that 35. Vertical speed. I'm going to do 1,000 feet per minute. I'm going to cut the engine, the throttle down to 50% since we're coming down with so much. Vertical speed. There you are. Well, we're going to be turning right here any moment. Good, short distance just there is the turn, 053. Just over 10 miles away. Just beyond the fork at the foot of a mountain is a runway you can land at. Well, that yet to be determined.
How far away is it from that?
10 miles. It was giving me almost 5 minutes, so we're doing about 2 miles.
Well, I'm going to have to go around this mountain then, because I don't have my altitude to get over it. I'm at 2,200 feet.
Okay, yep, I see you now. Yeah, you should probably be skirting the right-hand side of this mountain, as I should as well. This is where autopilot takes you, so... At 4,600, 1,000 feet left to go on my preset. I got my altitude set to go to 3,500, should be plenty once I get past this last little ridge here. I'm looking for the strip. So on the right hand side we are green trees, the left hand side we're almost a desert like. Alright, let me Let's drop another. Oops. And a 2100 vertical speed. 500 feet per minute. Alright, I think I might see the runway. Or no, I'm seeing a straight line. What's that?
So I'm just trying to decide if it's this thing along the river.
Looking at the picture? Or what you see on in a game?
On the game. I don't think that's it.
You look at the picture on a nav map. One side has trees, the other side is like desert.
All right.
So I am still on autopilot. Oh, I see it. Dead ahead. It's gotta be it.
Alright, I see it. Oh, moly. I gotta drop big time.
I'm on the ground.
I have to go around. I'm at 3,000 feet yet.
Congratulations, leg completed. 37 minutes. Not too shabby. Okay, so that was Bush Trip leg 13. So I believe it was only 14. One more to go. So that one's in the books. We will give it a save. Man, we'll think about maybe doing the last one. Who knows? We'll see.